If later on tonight I ask you to be my girlfriend.
This is working. Yes, it is. How's it going, guys? Well, as you guys may or may not know, my private or my social life has been revealed to you guys, or a part of it anyways, and it's been quite interesting. If you guys follow me on Instagram at Davis O Comedy, shameless plug, I revealed to you guys after, 4 years of being on YouTube, who my girlfriend is. And though we have not been together for 4 years, we've been together for quite a while. And you know what the funniest shit was, like, when I revealed to you guys that I had a girlfriend, the way you reacted was a little bit much.
No! No!
We, of course, had the classic, you know, but there was a lot of comments that I was reading that was very emotionally confusing for me, because it was like a compliment slash diss. I mean, you make up your fucking mind. David has a girlfriend. Wow, that's impossible. There's hope for the rest of us fat, ugly losers. Hey, man. Fuck you. How you gonna talk about me like I'm an exact replica of a butthole? But anyways, this woman to me, to say the least, is someone who is very special to me. But let's address a couple of things. And I know a lot of you guys are wondering, well, you know, if you had somebody that you really cared about and you loved, why didn't you want to share it with the world? Why didn't you put her on your social media, take pictures with her on Instagram, and blah, 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 blah? And to be honest with you, the simple answer to that is, I didn't want to. So when she and I started out, it was completely brand new. I didn't really know anything about her other than the fact that I met her through one of my friends. But when you're on social media, you kind of feel this pressure that you have to share everything with the world.
Girl, I know you really love me. You just don't.
But when it comes to developing a very serious relationship with somebody, I can't do that. You know, in the beginning when she and I started the relationship, it was a very important time for me, because those beginning moments are really where you begin to build your foundation with somebody. And to have that part of the relationship convoluted with social media and how other people were gonna leave comments, and I just didn't want that. And on top of that too, not everybody is built to deal with a lot of the pressures and comments and judgment that social media comes with. And you guys realize how strong and scary that shit is, especially on YouTube. But it's been quite a while since we've been together. The foundation is set. So I've tried to run multiple times. I can't, she'll find me.
Help me.
This shit suddenly turned into the Blair Witch Project and shit.
I'm so scared.
But yes, everybody, meet my girlfriend, Mariel. She's actually not here right now, but I'm gonna show y'all clips. To start off, let's just say this real quick. The bitch is crazy. You know, funny enough, before I even announced this, a lot of you guys actually already met her because she was in one of my sketches. Now, a few of you figured this out on my Instagram. She is someone who played multiple parts in that Korean Nike commercial. She played my wife. My girlfriend. And of course, she played my mom. I mean, there's a lot of reasons why I even approached her in the first place, or why I was even attracted to her, but one of the bigger reasons why she caught my eye was because, you know, her personality, she's very quirky, very weird. And I'm a bit of a sick freak in that way. I kind of like weird, quirky women. She was, it's just, maybe it was because she beat my ass. I don't know. Maybe I like women that scares me.
Our first outdoor activity adventure.
I wish to leave her already. If we were in the jungle.
Can't run, but you can't hide.
But you know, she and I have gone through a lot of growing pains in the time that we've been together. Before she and I even got together, I had planned to be single for a very long time, and I actually enjoyed my singledom. Is singledom a word? You know, in terms of settling down and meeting the one, it wasn't something that I was very interested in. I liked dating, I liked talking to multiple people, and I honestly didn't expect to look for a serious relationship until I was in my 30s. I felt like being in a serious relationship during my stage of life was a timeline that other people set for me. Like, in general, when you reach a certain age and you're not with somebody, people always ask, oh, why? Well, why the fuck not? Why do you have to be with somebody? I feel like in society, like, unless you're in a serious relationship, you're not really considered a successful human being or something that people need to pity. Well, fuck that. So for those of you out there who are single right now, it's really not that big of a deal, and you really need to stop saying, I need to be with somebody. You don't need somebody else to make you feel good about where you're at in life. You need to do that first on your own. Create a strong foundation, and then you are allowed to bring somebody else into that world. So obviously, prior to me meeting her, I had no notion of getting into a serious relationship. But as you guys may know, in the most cliche way possible, relationships happen when you least expect it. And it just came and just smacked me in the face. Literally.
Oh! Ooh!
of you guys have seen us together walking around LA, probably specifically in Little Tokyo in Japantown. That's our spot. I love Little Tokyo because the food scene there is amazing. The people there are dope. It's very clean. And on top of that, a couple of my favorite restaurants of all time are located there. And not only that, it's a really good like kick it slash date night spot, especially if you want to get to know a girl or something like that. There's a lot of places that you guys can walk around, snack on things, and there's dinner that you can grab there, or lunch or coffee. So if you guys ever want to take somebody out on a very casual date, you know, go to Little Tokyo, you know, set those moves in. A Little Tokyo is like our spot because that's where we spent a lot of our earlier memories together. We went on a lot of dates there, so you might catch us, you know, holding hands, doing cute stuff, you know, cupcaking and shit. But yeah, man, I guess you could say, I love her. Lightweight. I hope she sees this.
Leave our friends clueless. Now that's a perfect picture. Toast whoever Jude is. Besides you drinking all my champagne, you ain't new to this. Yes, I'm expecting it, undressing it.